వందేహం శ్రీ గురు శ్రీయుత పదకమలం.
Now, clearly explain. What is the purpose of yoga? They're very much proud of becoming yogi and attending yoga society and this and that and meditation. But here is the yoga practice. Clearly explain. But
yoga practice is not meant for attaining any kind of material facility. It is to enable the cessation of all material existence.
So long you will require some material facilities, you will get material facilities, but that is not solution of the problems of your life. Material facilities, I think, you American boys and girls, you have got material facilities better than any other nation, at least better than India. That I can say by my experience. And I have traveled in so many countries, in Japan also I have seen, but still you are better position. But do you think you have attained peace? Can any one of you say, yes, I am completely in peace? Then why the youngsters are so much frustrated and confused? So long we shall utilize this yoga practice, this practice, for some material facility, there is no question of peace. Yoga practice should be performed to understand Krishna, that's all. Or to make your lost relationship with Krishna re-established. That is yoga practice. Go on.
One who seeks an improvement in health or aspires after material...
Generally this yoga practice goes on in the name of improving health. Somebody goes to reduce fat, you see, reduce fat, because you are richness and you eat more and become fatty, and then again pay yoga practice fees and reduce your fat. That is going on. I've seen some advertisement the other day. Reduce your fat. Why you increase your fat? The nonsense they will not understand. If I have to reduce it, why I increase it? Why not be satisfied with simple foodstuff? If you eat grains and vegetables and light foodstuff, you'll never get. Right? You see? You'll never get fat. Reduce eating as much as possible. Don't eat at night. Practice yoga like this. If you become voracious eater, there are two kinds of diseases. The voracious eaters, they are attacked with diabetes, and those who cannot eat sufficiently, they are tuberculosis. So you cannot eat more or you cannot eat less. You just eat what you require. If you eat more, then you must be diseased. And if you eat less, you must be diseased. That will be explained. Yuktahara viharascha yoga bhavati siddhita. You are not to starve, but don't eat more. Our program, Krishna Prasadam, is that you eat Krishna Prasadam. Eating is required. You have to keep your body fit for any practice. So eating is required, but don't eat more. Don't eat less also. We don't say that you eat less. If you can eat, 10 pounds eat. But if you cannot eat 10 pounds out of avarice, out of greediness, if you eat 10 pounds, then you'll suffer. You see? So, here is the... what is that? No material facility. Go on.
Thank you. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna.